Sparky was a little boy who liked music, and he liked to sing. He particularly liked to sing out in front of his house, where he could see a big mountain. Whenever he sang there, his voice went all the way to the mountain, struck it, and bounced right back to Sparky, so that he could hear himself sing. It was an echo. And almost every day, Sparky sang his own little song to the mountain.
Hello.
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 How do?
How do?
You do?
You do?
You do?
Hello.
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 And how?
And how?
Are you?
Are you?
One day, as usual, Sparky stood in front of his house where he could see the mountain in the distance. And he began to sing his song.
Hello!
Well, that's funny. My voice didn't come back to me. I'll try it again. Hello? Hello? Oh, my goodness! Now my singing voice is gone. My song, it never came back. I can't sing anymore. Hello, hello. I can't sing. My song went to the mountain and never came back. What will I do? What will I do? Wait, I know. The animals in the forest are all my friends. They'll help me. I'll go off into the woods and ask them. I must find my singing voice or I'll never be able to sing again.
So Sparky went off into the woods to get some help from his animal friends. The first animal he came to was a bear.
Mr. Bear, have you seen my singing voice anyplace?
Seen your voice? Well, that's silly. How can you see a voice? A voice is a thing that must be heard, because you can't see the spoken word. To see a voice would be absurd. Absurd means silly, you know.
Oh, well, thanks anyway, Mr. Bear. I know you can't see a voice. That's what makes it so hard to find. Guess I'll just have to keep trying.
And poor Sparky went walking on through the woods, wondering if he would ever be able to sing again. As Sparky walked on through the woods, the next animal he met was a big, fat bullfrog sitting by a pond. The frog was singing.
I'm Fatso the Jolly Frog, harumph. I jump from log to log, harumph. Of singing I am very fond. My voice is deeper than this pond. Hello, Sparky. What can I do for you?
Oh, Fatso, you sing so well. And you know, I like to sing too, but I can't anymore. I sang my song and the echo never came back, and now my song is gone. Do you know where I could find it?
That's a tough one, Sparky. I'm afraid I can't help you. Why don't you ask the fish there in the pond? Maybe he will know.
Mr. Fish, do you know?
Now let me think. Let me see. That's too hard a question for me, Sparky.
So poor Sparky went on until he came to a little gopher digging a hole in the ground. It was Goony Gopher.
Hello, little boy. Can I help you? My name is Goofy the Gunner. Goony the Giver. I'm Goony the Gopher.
Goony, I lost my singing voice. Would you know where it is?
Well, I heard a voice down in my hole this morning. Maybe that's yours. Wait, I'll go down and look. Nope, that wasn't your voice, Sparky. It was my voice. I was talking to myself. No wonder they call me Goofy the Gunner, Goffy the Gunner, Ginny the Giffer. Well, glad to help you anytime.
Well, he was no help, but I have an idea. I'll ask the wise old owl. Mr. Owl, where can I find my voice?
Who knows? Who knows? Who knows?
Oh, man in the mountain, where is my song? I want to sing again.
Why, Sparky, it got caught in that cave over there. Wait, I'll move this rock and let it out. There you are, Sparky.
Oh, thank you, old man of the mountain. Now I can sing again.
Sparky was so overjoyed that he ran all the way home and stood in his favorite spot and sang, just as happy as he could be.
Hello.